Cisco SD-WAN custom topology is what we will implement in this section. As you know, default SD-WAN topology is full mesh. And in the last section, we implemented hub and spoke and mesh topology. Custom topology requires us to manipulate OMP routes and TLOC updates. This is the topology that we will implement in this section. Site 1 with site ID 101 is considered as hub site. Spokes with site ID from 102 to 104 can connect to each other but through hub site. Exactly like hub and spoke topology. But now there is an exception. Site 2 and site 3 must be able to connect directly to each other. Just to remind you, we have two type of route types in OMP routing protocol. OMP service VPN routes, or simply routes that point to the services behind WAN routers. In our topology, 172.16.1.2.3.4 subnets are OMP routes. And TLOCs, which point to the WAN routers themselves or WAN router locations. As you may remember, TLOCs are a mixture of system IP, encapsulation type, and color. In our topology, in site 1, for example, we have two TLOCs, 111.101, public internet and IPsec encapsulation, and 111.101, MPLS and IPsec encapsulation. I've reviewed OMP route types because we are going to manipulate these routes to create our custom topology. The question is how we will implement this custom topology. As you know, WAN routers advertise their OMP routes and TLOC to vSmart controller, and vSmart controller reflect them to other WAN routers. vSmart controller allow us to create our custom topology with manipulating and filtering OMP routes and TLOCs. For example, which routes and TLOCs are advertised to which routers with which preference can be easily controlled via vSmart controller. Routes and TLOCs can be filtered or manipulated in vSmart controller when it receives or advertise them. To implement this topology, nothing is changed in routes and TLOCs when they are advertised to hub site, since its connectivity is the same with default full mesh topology. Site 4 must be able to communicate with all sites but only through hub site. So all OMP routes are advertised to site 4, but TLOC of these routes are changed to hub site. For more security, we advertise only hub TLOC and all other TLOC will be filtered. Site 2 and site 3 policies are different since they must be able to communicate to each other, but the communication with site 4 only through hub site is possible. Therefore, all OMP routes are advertised to site 2 and site 3. But when routes belong to site 4, then TLOC will be changed to hub site. For more security, we filter also site 4 TLOC when it advertised to site 2 and site 3. To implement our custom topology, first, we create list of sites according to the common policy. Setting, policies, centralized policy, custom option, and then list. Already, we have got hub, spokes. So, we will create new sites. Site 2, underline site 3, since they have common policy, the site ID 102 to 103. For site 4, we create a different list because it has a different policy with site ID 104. We have the same policy for hub site 2 and site 3. So from 101 to 103. And also hub, which is already exists. Then we create a TLOC for hub site. Since in some rules in our policy, we have to change TLOC value to hub site. We already have created TLOC hub, but MPLS is preferred over internet in this list. Therefore, we create a new one in which both MPLS and internet have the same priority. So new TLOC list, hub underline location with TLOC IP 111.101, color public internet encapsulation IPsec, and again 111.101 with MPLS and encapsulation again IPsec, and then save. Now we need to create two policies, one to be applied to routes in VS Smart Controller when routes are advertised to site 2 and 3, the other when routes are advertised in site 4. So custom options and then topology. Add topology and custom control. First, outbound underline 2 underline site 2 underline site 3. Sequence type, as you can see, we have two type of routes to manipulate, routes and TLOC. We implement route and TLOC according to our policy. First, routes match site. When the site list is hub site 2 and site 3, then action accept, and then save. New sequence, when the site is site 4, again accept, but change TLOC to hub location. And the other routes by default are rejected. So routes belonging to hub site 2 and site 3 are accepted, but routes belonging to site 4 are accepted, but TLOC or the next hub or the location is changed to hub site. And again for sequence TLOC, and just for the security, we permit only TLOC locations related to hub site 2 and site 3, action accept, and by default the other TLOC will be rejected. So TLOC related to site 4 is rejected. So site 2 and site 3 through the hub site can communicate with site 4. And then save control policy. Now we create a policy for site 4. To site 4. Sequence type route. Sequence rule. Site. Hub site 2 and site 3, all are accepted, But TLOC location will be changed to hop location since site 4 can communicate to other site only through hop site. And then save. Hop site 2 and site 3 are accepted, but the TLOC location will be changed to hop location. And the other sequence type, TLOC, for more security, we permit only hop TLOC location. So, site, hop, then action, accept. The other TLOC will be by default rejected. Save, control, policy. Already we have a container policy with the name vsmartpolicy. We can use the same policy and replace old mesh topology policy with our new policy. So detach, add topology, import, custom, site 2 and site 3, again, import, custom, and site 4. VSmart controller must know where each policy must be used. So we have to configure to which routers and which direction each policy must be applied. So in policy application or apply the policy for site 4 and site, we have got two policy, outbound to site 4, which must be applied to site 4 in outbound direction. So site 4 and then add. We have another policy outbound to site 2 and site 3, which must be applied to site 2 and site 3, not in inbound but in outbound direction. So site 2 and site 3, and then add. We preview our configuration. As you see, we have got two policies, site 4 and site 2, site 3. In outbound to site 2, site 3 policy, any prefix belonging to hop site 2 and site 3 will be advertised. Any prefix belonging to site 4 will be advertised, but TLOC will be changed to hop site. For security reasons, TLOC belonging to site 2, site 3 and hop will be advertised, but site 4 TLOC will be rejected by default. In outbound to site 4 policy, any prefix belonging to site 2, site 3 and hop site will be advertised, but TLOC location will be changed to the hop site. And for security reason only, TLOC belonging to hop site will be advertised, and the other TLOC will be rejected since the default action is reject. So save policy and activate. Now we can check routing table of site 2 and site 4, for example, to make sure that it works as we expect. So this is site 2, IP route, VRF 10. As you see, site 2 is able to communicate with other site 2, site 3, site 1, and site 4, but with site 4 only through the hop site, the connectivity is possible. But with site 3 and site 1, there is a direct connection. So trace route 172.16.3.1 with source 172.16.2.1 VRF 10. There is a direct connection, but for site 4, the connectivity through hub site is possible. Since there is no priority over MPLS or over internet, the traffic is load balanced over both WAN transport. We can also check site 4 connectivity, show IP route VRF10. As you see, site 4 is able to communicate with other site, but only through the hub site.